Labyrinth, come in.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to finally do the review of the Diatone. I've been flying this guy for a pretty long while now. I probably put in around 60 lipos just to make sure he doesn't bug out on us like the previous one did. The previous one I had terrible problems with and I just kept replacing parts and nothing. I finally took him completely apart after even rebuilding him. However, this one's actually a different story to be honest. This one actually is holding up very well. It's taken a beating and as you can see it's full, you know, I mean, I had fun with him today, to be honest. However, this guy, you guys need to know, and you guys need to be careful, he is a battery destroyer. You will puff your lipos like no other. It's just insane. The amps that it needs just to get going. And so you're going to need some very, very good, powerful batteries. Yeah, I lost my antenna in a crash here, so I had an adapter. Anyways, you're going to need powerful lipos, or you have to be very careful on the throttle. So that's something to take note of. I did purchase a bunch of new Turnigy graphenes. They held up very well with this guy. However, I still did need to take a little bit easy on this guy. Overall, what first, you know, like just stock PIDs and stock everything, except the rates. The rates are very low, but I mean, everyone has their own rates. So I just changed the rates on this guy. I've done nothing else. Changed the rates, set up my receiver, and just been flying him. I didn't have to do anything except replace props, and that's really it. The motors, they're still pretty good. No noise. I've had a couple mean crashes, but these motors are just insane. Like the amount of amps they pull is just ridiculous. And the power, it's flight characteristics, how would I mention it? It's kind of like a slingshot, but like a very fast slingshot that lets you go. It's weird. You push that throttle and it's just like, and it just throws you, like all of a sudden you just get thrown, but you don't have to wait that long. If you have a very, very high C battery or a very good battery, that's the effect you're gonna get. It's just like, it just takes off and after a while, it's not instant, but you do get a big push in the beginning, but then it just surprises you with just this huge rush and it just feels like it just slingshots you. So it's pretty sick, it's pretty insane. It is a battery buster. You have to be very careful and use specific props. I ditched King Kong props. I've been using these now. I'm trying the bit more expensive props now because I ran out. And in Europe, I found a couple sites that will just ship up in a couple days. So I got these, the Dial Prop, what are these? 5046. They were good, actually. They lasted pretty well. I just kept bending them back, and they've been doing very good. There's also another one I have. It's the HQ something. I forgot it. I've just been flying that one all day, even bent up and everything. Just bend it back and just go fly. Towards the end of the day, I had a bunch of oscillations, but I really didn't care because I just wanted to fly that quad. Didn't bug me. But overall, this is actually a good buy. It's a good one, but you have to be very careful with your batteries. The antenna, however, something you might need to note. For me, it was different. They put so many, I'm not gonna be able to take this off now, but the O-rings here, what they put, the stock antenna, when you go to put it in all the way, it won't hold all the way, thus leaving it, you know how when you tighten it down, it gets stiff, but it'll stay loose. So if you lift it up like this while you're flying, it'll go over, smack these propellers, break your propeller, possibly break your antenna. That's what happened to me. So that's something to know. You might have to remove this to remove that circle piece of crap right there and just reclose it there and you'll be good to go. That's the only thing I could really think of that I really had to do. Use better zip ties because these will come off, that's for sure. And well, that's really it right now. I mean, it flies good, it's very powerful, it's very heavy. It will just completely annihilate your batteries if you're not careful. It'll just keep just sucking an amp as hard as it can out of your battery until it puffs up and just basically melts. Mine didn't melt, but I'm just saying puffs up and gets super hot. Motors come down pretty cool. There's nothing out of the ordinary. I have had any issues. I didn't have those the VTX crap that I had before where it just basically dies out of nowhere. while you're flying, it'll freeze and it'll melt. It's weird. But this has not. I've been running at 200 milliwatts the whole time. It's doing fine. Camera's good. We need to change the settings on the camera because the stock settings on this camera are crap. I couldn't really fly that well when the sun started to come down. It was just terrible. So we're gonna need, well, I'll probably make a video of us changing this together. This will need the settings changed on it. And, actually, it's a good buy, guys. I'm not gonna lie. This is a very good one. However, I will be trying to get the Holybro Copis or whatever. Just to see if it's really any good. I mean, this one's $280, that one's $300. And the B-Fight's on the way, it's $150. The B-Fight, I have very high hopes for, because $150, you could just get, you know, you can play with around with it and get used to it, and then all of a sudden just upgrade the motors anytime. Hopefully it'll handle that. So it'll be pretty sweet, possible, because it's I believe it's very light, if I remember correctly. I'm not sure yet. I don't remember, but I think someone said it was very light, so hopefully it'll be good. But overall, this one's a good buy. It's handling very well. The bearings are much better than the previous one, that's for sure. The VTX is a lot better. The flight controller is a lot better. They have redone this. It's a good... to be honest, I came in biased to hate it because of my previous one, but they proved me wrong, which is good, because I came here just to actually just nitpick every single bad thing about this guy. But so far, you know, the antenna is really nothing to nitpick about. And I wish they'd give you maybe more props and set up the settings for the camera. But you can do those yourself. And yeah, the bearings are good. I can tell you that. I've crashed it a lot. The bearings are handling very well. So I'm very happy with that. And that's it, guys. So I'm going to leave you guys with the flight footage. And I really hope it helped you out there. And if you guys hope you guys enjoyed it. And I will see you next time. See you guys. Take care.
Labyrinth, come in.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is something they call a groundbreaker. So let me first apologize to the shirts and the ties for your makeup. 'Cause I'll make you ugly as soon as it drops. We're on a rampage, bubbles popping up before you know it. There's rubble and dust, 'cause we'll be pushing it up. Somebody say, you better run. Yeah, I predict an earthquake up in here. Gentlemen, what you're about to witness is no illusion. And now we got the bass banging from here to Buckingham Palace. They're all moving. Hey Simon, working them up, turning them psycho. Everybody rock, let's bring the house down to rubble and dust, 'cause we'll be pushing it up. Somebody say, you better run. Yeah, I predict an earthquake up in here.
Ayo, Labyrinth, this one's feeling like a straight 10 on the Richter scale, you know? Yeah! Fire, fire, we about to set this place on fire. Without a match or lighter, don't do girlfriends. One night as make him C minor. If I want Christian or Kurt Geiger, I just phone up the designer. Doing all nighters, no days off, gray hairs and a little bit of weight loss. I predict, I predict, I predict, I predict. Disturbing London, got the whole city panicking. I've been Nostradamus, this my nip.